Suffering is bound to come. That is why, detached action is stressed upon. Because the whole purpose is to, go beyond this, this suffering actually, and feel free. It's not just about suffering, it's about feeling free. I started with three children in a rented building near Calcutta city. Three destitute children, orphan children, then children from red light areas, which means organized prostitution areas, where women were at some point in time brought. So
How are those
girls from
parents doing?
these, yeah, so girls from these prost red light areas who were daughters of women who were in prostitution. So this was my these were my initial domains. Similarly, children living on railway platforms who were like, say, child labor or just cleaning or begging on trains. So in a rented building I started near Calcutta, and then with some I actually without any funds I started, because I did not take up any job, but I needed some money to start this. Then only I could put it before others to support, right? When nothing has been done, who will support you? So I started taking lectures in Calcutta city for entrance exams for MBA institutes like, say, IIM, etc. There are highly competitive exams in India where lakhs of, hundreds of thousands of candidates appear. I began to take lectures in some of these institutes, so that helped me with some, you could say, seed funding, self-generated seed funding, with which I rented a building, and with, say, 15, 20 children, I was able to meet expenses of myself, recruited three, four persons as a workforce. Slowly, then my batchmates, my close friends, some alumni of our institute, IIM, began to support. I wrote to many of the alumni. So some began to visit also, and when they visited, they saw firsthand, so the word spread even faster. It was also an unusual story, because most IIM alumni, it was quite unusual for an IIM grad to have not gone into a normal, corporate career, which was expected of that person, and instead started something like this. So I think it had a novelty value maybe. So the word spread faster than it would have otherwise. So this connected more and more people, and then I could purchase some land in 2004. I started in 2003. In 2004, toward the end of 2004, we purchased a parcel of land. We built a first set of buildings there. So now it's in multiple geographies. We have on-campus schooling, and after that also we put kids into university level education or employability programs. So the end result is everyone gets has a job and is socially independent, socially on one's own feet, and a confident independent existence. It has 2,200 plus residential children in our these Bengal campuses. And then we in last 3 years or so I started in Madhya Pradesh, a different model. I built up a huge cadre of, in tribal areas, in villages. Tribal area, the indigenous groups, tribes, who are in some of the most backward, most impoverished parts of the country. So we have in 135 villages for nearly 12,000 children, we run educational centers where meals are also provided to them. So it's a nutritional meals cum education program covering 12,000 children. It's non-residential, but in venues which are offered by the villages. So we don't build up any infrastructure there. It's all given free by the community. So it's a very community involving model, and it's in five different districts. District is a certain administrative unit in India. So five different districts in the central Indian state of Madhya Pradesh. This is also scaling. We perhaps will have 300 or 500 such units covering maybe 50,000 children in next 5, 6 years, and then we'll see like what the future has in store for us, because some new concept, new models can also come up. Like this, the daytime model is called Seva Kutir, where children come in two shifts, in the morning 3, 3.5 hours, and in the late afternoon or evening 3, 3.5 hours, which includes not just education, sporting activities, arts and culture activities, civic virtues, volunteering, community, lessons, etc. We serve a very nutritious breakfast in the morning shift and a full-fledged dinner in the evening shift. So these two, for both the shifts, children are coming. And daytime, during the middle daytime, we also send the children to a local government school everywhere. So we are also involving the government, and there the afternoon meal is served by the government. So the whole, the day's cycle that therefore gets completed, and it has brought together government, it has brought together local communities. So all are, stakeholders and participants in this program. I actually, right from day one, basically my feeling was that these are, my life is given to them, and I don't know whether you know, but I never married also. Okay, wow. So, because then I thought that these are my children. I have enough to do in my life. I don't need a separate, private, smaller family of my own to call my own. This itself is my own. When certain clarity comes, then one tries to go for the kill. I went for the kill, basically, in the sense that then I thought that I have to go all out now in this pursuit. So why to have anything which is suboptimal? So I had my share of sufferings too, simply because a lot of this, these relationships or how I approached the children with whom I was living, I think it was not completely detached. So I was also sentimentally caught that they would I would be their hero for all of their lives, or they would this kind of value system they will absorb, or they'll see the world through the lens that I am giving them, right? But they have their, everyone has their own traits, and everyone, you can't program a human being. Living human being cannot be programmed formulaically. So that has led to a lot of suffering, in the sense that whenever attachments are there, suffering is bound to come. That is why detached action is stressed upon, because the whole purpose is to go beyond this this suffering, actually, and feel free. It's not just about suffering, it's about feeling free. Because then you feel bound also, and because then something is affecting you means you are bound. It's not suffering per se, but it means that you are bound. So the idea is that freedom is not there. If freedom is there, then suffering won't be there, because nothing will bother you then. Vivekananda also said, and Vedanta also emphasizes on this, that the freedom is the highest goal. Everything, every atom of the universe is trying to break free, basically. Trying to achieve higher and higher freedom, yeah.
So really it came from an emotion as opposed to a cerebral...
Correct. It did not come at all from a cerebral thing. There was nothing cerebral about it. In fact, the work we do is very, very simple. I don't think it has any challenging cerebral content, which we can say is fancy stuff, right? It's execution. Of course, when you reach a certain scale, then execution becomes a very important thing. But what I'm saying is that there is no grandiose, cerebral idea which no one else had thought of and you thought of. Nothing like that. It's these are plain ideas which we are trying to implement in an efficient manner, in a high empathy manner. That is most important. I think even over efficiency, I would prioritize high empathy. When you are one with the people you are serving, you feel oneness. There is not much distance. So the people who are serving are completely aligned. They feel what is needed. They understand their sensibilities, and approaching from that perspective, they are offering whatever service delivery is there. So high empathy is very important.
Were there any financial hardships during the journey that you felt that you couldn't support yourself or the children you were with?
No, I was, look, I always had personally very, very minimalistic kind of living. I was living in my institution only. I never had any house of my own. I still do not have any house of my own or any assets of my own. So I've lived in my institutions only. So all work or all travel I do is also for work only. So that way, like personally, I never, had any kind of, I never felt any needs also, so I never felt difficulty also managing this kind of lifestyle that I had. But it wasn't that the children whom we have already have are not being, cannot be looked after because of lack of resources. At least the work in hand never suffered, even if scaling was maybe suspended because of certain like slowdown periods. And that was not, that those were like general macro situations, say like the global slowdown which happened around 2009. So even organizations like ours felt a pinch, but the work in hand was never materially affected.
Beautiful, thank you.
This man has been looking after hundreds of children from deprived families by giving them quality education and inculcating in them high moral values.
One day it struck me that I should start a shelter home for children from very difficult backgrounds, and to whom I could dedicate my whole life. I could bring them up as my own.